Welcome back to CryptoThrone. In this video, we'd like to discuss Chainlink, how it's currently performing, and what we could expect during the upcoming hours and days. But before doing so, I would highly appreciate it if you could give me a thumbs up. And even more important, there are only 2 days left until the Bybit deposit bonus of 4,100 USD Tether will be gone. So do not forget to take advantage of this major opportunity to earn 4,100 USD Tether deposit bonus by signing on Bybit and using the link down below. So that is absolutely important. So let's get right away to Chainlink. Well, I opened up the 4-hour time frame, and what I think is actually quite important to know is that if we head towards the daily time frame and we zoom out a little bit further, what you can see is that for the very first time right now, we have created this first higher low on the chart. So this is absolutely important. This is actually showing us that we are actually seeing that trend reversal getting started, and we are seeing the movement towards the upside taking place. What else could we expect? Well, if we head towards the 4-hour time frame and we zoom in a little bit closer, what I would like to place right away is actually a curve trend line. Why I would like to place this curve is because I personally think that it is very likely that we are going to head in this direction, and therefore I would like to take this curve as our approximate measurement to see if we are going to stay inside of this parabolic run-up towards the upside. So therefore I place this ascending support and as well this curve trend line. For sure, something I would like to see is that we would like to see a stronghold getting created and stay on top of this trend line for a while, seeing that increase in price action taking place. So today, what I would like to discuss firstly is actually the RSI. And let's get started by enabling it right away. So what you can see on the 4-hour time frame is actually something that does concern me. We are trading quite high on the RSI. We already broke out above the dotted line once, and therefore I personally think it would be actually quite healthy if we would start seeing a decline taking place on the price action of Chainlink, due to the fact that we are clearly seeing right now that Chainlink is quite overextended on the relative strength index. This is showing us that we could expect a decline taking place, and therefore I'm actually right now quite confident that this is actually the best case scenario for Chainlink to see a decline. And for sure, what we would like to see is a stronghold getting found on top of the 23.6 Fibonacci at approximately $21.21. So that is for sure a level where we would like to stay on top of if we do right now see a decline taking place. So if we head towards the 1-hour time frame, what you can see right away is that we have seen this bearish divergence taking place. The reason why is because if we take a quick look here, we have been creating these slightly higher highs, but on the RSI, we have seen this lower highs ever since then. So we have seen this bearish divergence taking place on the chart and as well on the RSI. So right now, clearly we are seeing a bearish divergence. And what I think is quite good to know is that we are as well quite high on the 1-hour RSI, and we are nearby the dotted line on the upper part. Therefore, if we are right now going to experience a decline, it will be actually quite healthy for the overall trend, due to the fact that we would like to see more space on the RSI afterwards to see further continuation towards the upside. So a decline right now is not specifically a bad thing to see. If we enable right away the MACD on the 1-hourly time frame, what you can see is that we already experienced momentum towards the downside, but we were heading towards a crossover to create momentum towards the upside. But right now we are seeing this 1-hourly candle clearly declining in price action, and therefore I personally think that we are going to see actually a continuation of this decline in price action, and we are not going to see a crossover taking place. And I think this is actually very healthy due to the fact that we have seen both RSIs a bit overextended and as well a bearish divergence on the 1-hourly time frame. If we head towards the 4-hourly time frame, you can clearly see that we already experienced major momentum towards the upside, and therefore it would be actually as well quite healthy to see a decline and a crossover of momentum towards the downside to see even more continuation towards the upside afterwards. So right now on the MACD, what I'm expecting is that we are going to experience a crossover on the 4-hourly time frame, and we are going to see a decline in price action. So this being said, I would like to actually discuss during this video what the possible scenarios are and where we are going to find the strongholds of support underneath us. So for sure, the 23.6 Fibonacci at $21 is going to be a stronghold of support. We have already found support on top of this previously. We also experienced, well, resistance underneath it. We found support on top of it. And if we head even further, well, if we extend this line, you will see that this is actually a very important range, due to the fact that we have been able to find well, support on top of it, as you can clearly see here, support on top of it, but as well, resistance underneath it, support on top. So this is a level with multiple touch points, and therefore I'm actually convinced that we are going to see a stronghold getting started once we decline in price action right now on Chainlink. What else is actually important to see? So if we place a fixed range volume profile from swing low towards swing high, what you can see right away is that the most amount of volume was traded at $18.89. Therefore, if we do see actually a breakdown occur below the $21, we will still see this major stronghold underneath us serving as a level of support. But what I would like to see personally is a stronghold, of course, taking place on top of the 23%, because we would like to see that parabolic increase still taking place, and we would like to see this curve trend line holding strong. So that is for sure something I would like to see during the upcoming hours. And what else is actually very important? Therefore, I would like to enable the EMA ribbon. So the EMA ribbon on the 4-hour time frame is actually aligned perfectly with the 23% Fibonacci. Therefore, I'm actually convinced that this is going to be a stronghold of support at $21. And if we do see a further decline underneath it, the $18 for sure will be a stronghold underneath us, but it's a level that I would prefer not to see getting reached, and I would like to see a stronghold on top of this range is taking place, due to the fact that that would be better for the overall trend as well. Right now I would like to enable one more fixed range volume profile from swing high towards swing low in the immediate short term, and what you can see is that underneath us as approximately $20.27 we do still have as well a level of support. So if we do not hold strong on top of the $21.21 range, we could perhaps see a minor decline even further, heading towards the $20.27 and finding support on top of this range before heading straight back up once more and head towards the upside, still getting supported by the 4-hour EMA ribbon. If we head towards the 1-hour EMA ribbon, what you can see is that it's right now currently supporting the trend, but perhaps we are going to see that minor decline taking place towards the 23% Fibonacci, and therefore we will be once more retesting the EMA ribbon as a level of support and see afterwards increase towards the upside once we have seen enough decline on the RSI to experience major momentum towards the upside afterwards. So thank you very much for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed the content so far. If you did, do not forget to give me a big thumbs up down below. It will be highly appreciated, and you will be supporting the channel by doing so. So thank you very much and have a nice day.